Linda Daydal, MMA Connect TV at the Coliseum Gym in Ballyfermot with Mr. Pete Taylor.
How you doing?
How are you?
Good, thanks, good.
That was great. We got a little invite into Fight Camp with Pete. Yeah, it was really, really good to see the drills that you're doing and the technique and everything.
Yeah, that was an easy session today for the lads. Luke's winding down for his fight on Saturday, and Davey's a fight in Glasgow the following week. Yep. So the two of them are tapering now, and Gary and Sean are a little bit away from fight, so I'm not killing them at the moment.
So what way do you kind of structure it out? You know, like, obviously, is it kind of like 6 weeks out, it's kind of high intensity, and then it filters down, or what kind of structure do you have?
We constantly train all the time, you know, but if they're 12 weeks out, we'll only be on one session a day.
Yeah.
Then when it comes to 8 weeks out, we go for the two sessions a day. Then 10 days before, then we go down to one session a day again, just to taper.
Yeah.
You need loads of energy. You're not going to get fit in the last 10 days.
Yeah,
you're
exactly,
just going to get sharper, you know?
Absolutely. And just watching you with all the you know, the drills and the movement, and you're watching everything in so much detail. Like, obviously, that's a huge part of your role as a coach.
Yeah, I love the technical part of the boxing. Yeah. I love it. It's very difficult at the moment.
Yeah.
Trying to demonstrate. But I love it. I love that part of it. And it keeps you interesting for the lads, and try to change the drills up all the time. You're always trying to invent new drills for them, which is sport specific.
Yeah.
And just to challenge them as well, which is important.
Of course. And like, obviously, we've seen a lot of kids now that are you know, starting in boxing again. We're starting to see sort of a resurgence in boxing coming up. You know, it's starting to like get really cool again for younger kids. Yeah. They're like, oh, I want to box. You know, they're seeing people like Gary Cully, like Luke, and doing really, really well. How have you seen a change since you started?
PlayStations.
That's a big thing. Well, it is a thing, isn't it? You know what I mean? Getting kids off video games.
Getting the kids off video games. I think they'd rather have a PlayStations Olympics than a boxing Olympics. And then obviously the big surge in MMA.
Yeah.
So we've taken a lot of the boxers away as well, you know, which is not a bad thing as well, because the MMA lads have to learn boxing as well. And some of them are doing both sports as well, which is great, you know. I think both of them can complement each other, you know.
Absolutely. And we start to see it as well with guys who started out in MMA. You'll always see them going to a boxing club or do boxing on the side, because they realise the importance of boxing in the game. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, they always have a go at it as well. And obviously, it's two completely different sports. It's like rugby and football, but I think they both can complement it. The MMA training have no history.
Yeah.
And so everything's very scientific in what they do. Where boxing's got a lot of history, so a lot of people don't want to change.
Yeah.
Where a lot of the coaches should look at some of the MMA coaching and they can learn from that, because it's a new sport, you know.
Yeah. In terms of coaching and your coaching experience, you know, you're obviously one of the top level coaches that are out there. For people who are aspiring to be like you as coaches, what advice would you give them, or what? How do they get to your level?
I think first you've got to go hands on and start teaching the kids, you know, and just be open to everything anybody says, and then try it, and then adapt it to your own ideas, you know. Yeah. So if somebody shows you something, a drill, you like it, but adapt it to your own ideas, you know. It's and listen to everybody. Everybody has, you know, you look at some coaches and you think, you might not think they're great, but every coach has something.
Yeah.
You know, and I think the most important thing about coaching is having a relationship with your boxers.
Yeah.
Or a relationship with your fighters, you know, that's the most important thing. And I think every coach has done well with their boxers or fighters. They've had a good relationship with them. That's why so many father-sons, father-daughter relationships work well in the ring, you know. Like the top amateur boxers have been the same. James Moore, Jim Moore, Michael Carruth, and, you know, and Austin, they've all, you know, all done well, you know.
Absolutely. And we see it time and time again as well with a lot of kids that, you know, maybe come from disadvantaged backgrounds that start in boxing gyms or martial arts academies, that maybe don't have that relationship with their father or their mother.
Yeah.
And then they get that in the gym,
Exactly.
How important do you think that is to the development of them as athletes as well?
It's everything. I have kids that have been in the club years, and then you'd meet them 15, 20 years later. They'll always remember you, you know.
Of course, yeah.
And you always have that relationship with them. And I know that from myself, from the accident I had there a few months ago, like the messages of support I got from all the lads I trained from years and years ago, you know. And you know, you see, you can save a lot of these kids, you know. And it's important. And not everybody's going to be a champion, you know, and you've got to take that. You can't just focus on the champions. Not everybody will be a champion, but just got to give them the best you can, you know.
How hard is that as a coach with you? You know, where obviously you have people that maybe put in 100% effort, but you know in your heart they're not going to be champions. Do you know, like, are you brutally honest with them, or do you just, like, how does it work? It's a tough game, right?
They're the best they're going to be, you know, and once they're giving me 100%, I'll give them 100%, you know. You know, and you've just got to match them accordingly, you know.
Yeah.
You know, the most important thing is to be honest to them.
Yeah.
Honest with them. They might not all be world champions, but they're going to be the best they can be. So they're champions anyway, you know, that's the way I look at it. And once these kids give me 100%, I'll give them 100% back, you know.
100%. And before I let you go, we're going to just get Gary in now. What would you say is the most important detail that you look for in a student? Because you've trained so many champions. So what is the one detail that they need to have?
Discipline.
It's
discipline. Everything's discipline, you know. Some days you don't want to turn up training. That's the days you've got to turn up training. That's the days that make you champions, you know. I mean, your coach is there for every session. So it's disrespectful if you're not there for every session, you know. And, discipline. And when some people haven't got the most talent in the world, but the discipline, and they come on to be champions.
Yeah.
And some people have got all the talent in the world, but no discipline, and they get nowhere, you know?
Yeah, of course,
So discipline beats everything, you know, in our training.
Brilliant. Well, hopefully someone out there listens to that. But listen, thank you very much. A pleasure to meet you, and it was great to drop in today. Pete Taylor for MMA Connect TV. Super, thank you.